I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
Hey, this month on Grumble and Glorify, we're going to look at something a bit more recent. It has been a while since I've looked at something modern, you have to admit. That'll change, don't worry. What I'm looking at this month is a DVD-only release that became available to the public just this January of 2009. It's called Hulk Versus. Hulk Versus what or who, you ask? Well, I'll tell you, just keep your purple pants on, okay?
Aye, we won the day.
I'll begin with the first film that I saw, Hulk vs. Thor. Now, the question of who is the strongest has been a big question for a very long time. There have been epic battles in the comics, and the battle between Hulk and Thor even came to us in television form in 1988 in The Incredible Hulk Returns. Now, over 20 years later, we can see that epic battle still raging on. The story of Hulk vs. Thor involves Thor's evil stepbrother, Loki. He has taken Bruce Banner and requires the power of the Hulk to deliver Thor to an early grave. Of course, Banner is reluctant to let the Hulk out, so Loki resorts to different measures to anger Bruce and then has this gal perform some magic whammy on the Hulk to gain control of him. Yes, I know her name, I just like saying this gal. Okay, moving on. So now the Hulk has become basically a puppet, and it's up to Thor and his allies to stop the Hulk from destroying Asgard. Relax, folks. I'm not going to spoil the ending. This is as far as I'm going to go with the story. The rest you'll have to watch. I should warn you, this film is not intended for the kiddies. I know kids love the Hulk, but unless you as the parent want to chop up this film and leave out the violence and bloody details and more or less sanitize and neuter Hulk vs. Thor for the kid, keep this one between those who can handle it. Adults. On to my thoughts on this film. Even though it's only 45 minutes in length, the story we're given is phenomenal, especially when complemented with the fantastic voice acting and how awesome Fred Tatasciore is as the voice of the Hulk. This guy has got a f***ing set of lungs. Let's talk about the animation and the art style for this film, because it does differ from Hulk vs. Wolverine, which we'll get to in a minute. Many scenes are very bright, detailed, loaded with color, and has great visual effects. I love how each character looks, though I think the Hulk could use a haircut. It's hard not to talk at great lengths about the plot and how you start to feel for each character after a certain length of time. Marvel was always famous for that in the comics, so it's nice to see that done here. So there you go, a highly recommended animated film with lots of action and enough violence to satisfy. But what about Hulk vs. Wolverine? I'm glad you asked. In Hulk vs. Wolverine, your favorite X-Men, Logan, is asked to track down the Hulk, and if he can't be stopped, kill him. Sounds reasonable. This was yet another epic battle that I don't recall seeing in animated form before, at least not while I was growing up. I know Hulk was in an episode of Wolverine and the X-Men, but no, that's not what I mean. So Hulk and Wolvie have it out for a while, and at some point Sabretooth along with Deadpool, Omega Red, and Lady Deathstrike take them both prisoner. Okay, this is where I stop. This is only a 37-minute film, so why tell you the rest? I do want to point out some things. Don't misunderstand me, I like this film too. It's just a few things I've noticed. First, Bruce Banner is a pussy. For some reason, he seemed more believable as a tortured soul on the Versus Thor film. And yes, Bruce Banner is voiced by the same guy, Bryce Johnson. Yeah, I know we're dealing with differences in writers or directors or whatever, but at least have some consistency. There's a fine line between being a tortured character and a goddamn crybaby. Trust me, if you watch the films one after the other, you'll notice and you'll be asking the same questions that I've been asking. Now, while the film isn't shy on violence and blood, the art style is different from Versus Thor. And character styles like Sabretooth seem to lean towards a kid's cartoon. Maybe I'm wrong, he just looks kind of funny. He looked more menacing in the 90s X-Men cartoon. I don't know, let's move on. You know, I almost forgot to mention Wolverine. Steve Bloom, who voices him, he did a great job here. At least they didn't give him an Australian accent like they did in the 80s. It's gruff, just has that badass motherfucker written all over him. It's all good, man. This is also on my recommendation list. Both films are on the same DVD. You can pick it up at a very reasonable price. That is all I have to say about Hulk Versus, other than check it out, or Hulk get mad.
Ugly girl scratch Hulk.